Hello, I'm Chris. In this video, I'm going to show you how to steer a car correctly using a pull-push method. It's the safest way of steering and is used by professional drivers such as the police. We saw in a previous video how to do the pull-push steering in a car park. I'm now going to demonstrate the steering in real situations on the road. When steering, your hands should never cross over, so your right hand always stays to the right half of the steering wheel and your left hand stays to the left half, and they must never cross over. To steer around this right hand corner, I'm going to grip with my right hand, so it's going to start at the top. I pull down with my right hand, push up with my left. Grip with my left, push up with the right hand. It takes good control to make sure you straighten the wheels just at the right point. For some turns, you will have to steer a lot and quickly, using the whole size of the steering wheel. Sometimes it requires full lock, maximum steering. I'm going around the left-hand corner, but steering back just at the right time so I don't oversteer towards the parked cars. You should hold the steering wheel at a 1/4 to 3 position or at 10 to 2 like I'm demonstrating here. One reason why you don't want to cross your arms when steering is that if the airbag ever explodes out of the center of the steering wheel, then you don't want your arms to be in the way of it. You should keep both hands on the steering wheel unless you need to operate a control. I'm taking the next road on the left. When to turn is very important. If I turn too late, I'm going to swing out wide. Turn too early, I will hit the curb. After the turn and you need to straighten the wheels, make sure you keep in full control and don't let the steering wheel spin through your hands. At the mini roundabout, I will turn right. I will grip with my right hand, pulling it down, pushing up with my left hand, and continue to feed the steering wheel through. Planning ahead, I can see an oncoming car, so I'm going to use this space. Thinking about how I'm going to get out of the space as well. Now big turns to the right, steering to the left so I don't swing out too much, and then straighten in the wheels. I'm turning left at the end of the road. How much steering to give really depends on the turn. A common problem when coming out of a tight space is swinging out towards the parked cars on the other side of the road, so make sure you steer back to the left in time and then straighten the wheels. I'm turning right at the mini roundabout and it looks really tight. There's parked cars in the way as well, so I'm going to steer a little bit left. I've got no choice but to drive over this roundabout to avoid these parked cars, steering back to the left so I don't swing out towards the white car. At the mini roundabout, I'm going to turn left. Giving way to my right, steering left, feeding the steering wheel through using that pull-push method of steering, being ready for oncoming. Some mini roundabouts are impossible to go around properly, especially when there's parked cars in the way. So I'm steering around the parked cars. At this roundabout, I'm going to turn right. Again, impossible to drive around properly. I'm in first gear, steering left to swing round. really trying my best to go round the roundabout, using the pull push method of steering here as I steer back to the left to straighten the wheels. Well, that's the end of our video on the pull push method of steering. As usual, I really hope it's been useful, and we really appreciate you watching our videos. If you haven't subscribed already, then please do. Stay safe on the road, and see you soon.